church, the Jazz and Justice Church. So glad to be back with you. For all of you joining on Zoom, welcome. Can we turn and wave to our Zoom family? Hi, Zoom family. So good to see you. And if you, you know, for those of you in the sanctuary, welcome. A warm, warm welcome today. It's a beautiful, wonderful day. And if you're joining us for the first time, or if you haven't had a chance to meet you, or you just wondering, like, where the heck am I? Because I've been here. Well, I'm Reverend G. Jeffress. I'm the associate pastor here. I was on vacation for 2 weeks and planned to come right back. I caught COVID. So it turns out COVID, you know, sucks the life out of you, and I was sick for 2 more weeks and I wasn't here, but I'm back now. So, wonderful to be here, worshiping with you. Our senior pastor, Reverend Marjorie Matthews, is with her family today after the big celebration of life that we had here yesterday for her dearly departed Reverend Bob Matthews, her husband. So let's hold Marjorie and her family in prayer today as they, you know, continue their grief journey together on this day. So, and I just want to offer gratitude for yesterday. If you were here yesterday helping out, will you stand up? You just don't be shy. We do this around here a lot. Stand up. Look at the seat. Take a moment to feel your feet on the floor. We know that your presence is anything but virtual. We know that you are here. Share with us your grace so that we can share it with each other. Share your light so that we can be the light for each other. Be with us as we seek to be in your presence. In your blessed name we pray. Come, Holy Spirit. Amen. And with this prayer on our hearts, we claim once again the wisdom from Psalm 46. I invite you to repeat each line after me. Be still and know that God is God.
Be still and know that God is God.
Be still and know that God is.
Be still and know that God is.
Be still and know.
Be still and know.
Be still.
Be still.
Be.
The storm is passing.
precious community.
Faithful.
Will you please join me now as we claim anew those words that are so precious to us in our denomination, the United Church of Christ. No matter who you are or where you are on life's journey, you are welcome here. You are warmly welcome. And in that spirit of welcome, I invite you to first pass the peace to yourself, laying a gentle hand on yourself and saying, "Peace be with me." And now I invite you to pass the peace to everyone who's gathered here today, reaching out your hands and saying, "Peace be with you." If you're worshiping with us for the first or second time today, thank you for coming. For those who are here in the sanctuary, if you'd like us to have your contact information so we can reach out and get to know you, there's cards that look like this in the back of the pews, and that's a place for you to put your contact information. For those of us worshiping on Zoom, our wonderful Zoom host will post a link in the chat, and that link will take you to a digital version of that same card. And now we're going to have some time to continue passing the peace to each other. If you're worshiping with us on Zoom, you'll have a few minutes in small breakout rooms to pass the peace to each other and share a sentence or two about how you're doing. For those here in the sanctuary, you can rise and greet each other. If you're erring on the side of caution and don't want to hug or shake hands, you can welcome elbow bumps or air hugs. Recognizing the spirit of the risen Christ in each of us and in all of the scattered community, let us greet each other with a sign of peace.
I'm actually Terry Dunn, who's going to walk in any minute, and you can all look at it. Many of us who are in the third age of life want to age consciously. And we want to navigate these years with purpose and hope. And there is a new group forming, as I said last week, called the Conscious Saging. And I want to just say, some people are coming who are in their 50s. You are self. If you want to come and you are younger than 60, you are still welcome. Saging can be defined as a spiritual practice for harvesting and sharing wisdom as a legacy for future generations. Our first gathering will be a midday retreat on Saturday, October 26th from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. and it includes a lunch and contemplative individual practices and starting a community conversation about how we as the elders of Plymouth will live into the future. So please see me if you'd like to sign up during fellowship time or contact Terry or me through the sign up details in the bulletin.
We heard yesterday that Bob's favorite color was sage green. So I think this is really an honor to Bob. Anyway, I'm going to talk about the Winter Coat Drive, which you've all heard, many of you, others maybe for the first time. Thank you, Hillary. She's reminding me to keep it up here. So anyway, for those of you who don't know, we partner with a school in West Oakland, and we do a coat drive that we've been doing for almost 8 years except for COVID. It's a school in West Oakland called Hoover Elementary School. And we get coats for a lot of the kids there. There's over 60 kids that we have names of who need coats. And we're down to about 5 that only need coats. So, yeah, it's very impressive. Student, their family and the staff, and teachers at Hoover Elementary School. In past years, some of you have placed gloves and hats in the coat pockets or a special blessing or gift. But please, no gifts of cash and no food to me. We don't want any critters to give. So we will be blessing these coats on November 3rd, so you can bring them then, or if you need to bring them before,
Estella or I will take them. And I have little colorful cards here that I will give you once you sign up, and then you'll have the name, the teacher, all the information on the code that you use. So please see me, as Lois said, in the fellowship room afterwards. Thank you all.
As Lois said, we have to go to Perry Dunn.
Very quickly, Wednesday night, 6:30, at the Grand Lake Theater is the showing of The Strike, which is the documentary about and you can get tickets. I'll be there. Several of us will be there. It'll be an important thing to watch.
Well, it is birthday Sunday today, so I want to invite all of you who have October birthdays, don't be shy, because this is a place of lots of love and care. Come on up. If you're on Zoom, please put the name of your loved one or yourself in the chat. If you have a birthday, look at these birthday people. Yes, Stephen is very shy. All right. Birthday people. And then for those of you who would like to bless and lay hands on the birthday folks, come up. For the rest of you, just extend your hand out with some love for our birthday people. Birthdays are important. All right, look at all the love here. Okay. So take this birthday blessing in October, loves. May you be a song with a melody that anchors, a harmony that inspires, and a refrain that nurtures. May your music lift someone's spirits, offer healing and hope. May it be a gift to you and others. May it ring true to the life that is yours, and may you sing it boldly. Happy birthday to you, and may God bless your new year of life. Amen. Amen. So as we patch our words together today, let's also listen deeply for what the Holy is trying to say to us and maybe through us. If you're here in the sanctuary, you can raise your hand. prayer this morning.
Holy Spirit, I profoundly ask that you have our government have a change of heart about supporting the genocide in Gaza, and have everyone see that that makes no sense and that we need to recover in that part of the world.
God of justice, hear our prayers. Justice, hear our prayers. And I'm going to come and see what our family on Zoom has to say today.
From Susan Solverson, prayers for my Aunt Janet's family as they say goodbye as she passes into the arms of Jesus. God, who is with us in our grief, hear our prayers. From Laura Easley, blessings to Laura and Lisa's cousin, Sarah, and her new husband, Jordy, who got married yesterday. Blessings to love in this world. God of love, hear our prayers. From Yancey Taylor, prayers of healing for my friend Teresa Wagner, whose cancer came back. God of healing, hear our prayers. From Susan and Bernard, comfort for Pastor Marjorie as she lives a new life and grieves the loss of Bob, and her gratitude for knowing him. God of comfort, hear our prayers. From Christine Harris, please be with my dear friends Winnie and Helen, both of whom are back in the hospital battling different cancers. God of healing, hear our prayers.
Hear our prayers, O God. We know that when we pray so that we can change. We might not be able to change something, but we change, and that in and of itself creates a change. We pray, God, for our world so broken and filled with war, so filled with people who are power hungry. We pray for mercy on those suffering. We pray for those who are sick right now, God, who are stuck at home or in the hospital. We pray for our community and those who are shut in or who are depressed. We lift them up and we pray that they feel our love. We pray for our Pastor Marjorie as she journeys with her family today to spread the ashes of her beloved husband. We hold them in our hearts. We pray that your comfort is there. And we pray for everyone who is going through something right now. Just anything, depression or anxiety. There's so much anxiety, so much fear. We pray that you lift the fear, God. We turn our fears to you. We know that you are a change maker when we follow. Join us. Join me in this prayer. Holy One, hear our prayers. Be with us as we pray for each other and for the world. Be with all your people working for peace, wherever they may be. And help us to be your people, a people of courageous love, a people of just peace. Help us to be your people, using our power to help the powerless, using our freedom to free another. Help us to imagine a world where all your people are free and have a place to call home. And help us to create that world that we can imagine. Help us to be a people of courage and willingness to love each other as you love us. And join me in the prayer that Jesus taught the disciples when they asked, "Teacher, teach us to pray." The words are in your bulletin. Our Creator God, who is in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever.
Thank you. Misericordia para siempre. Thank you, beloved God, because your mercy is forever and your grace fills our hearts. Let us now listen to this message and open our hearts to what the Spirit is moving in us. In Jesus I pray, amen.
Amen.
You might have noticed I have a theme in my preaching these days. A couple of months ago, I preached here on Jacob demanding a blessing and not letting go of the angel until it happened. And today, I will talk about a humble widow insisting to an unjust judge to hear her plea. So you can call this the theology of stubbornness. You can call this the spirituality of not taking no as an answer. The faith that moves mountains. Yes, this is my thing these days, siblings. An annoying cry for those who want justice and want it now.
Yes, yes, yes.
In a biblical commentary that I was reading in preparation for today, Luke is called the Gospel of the Poor, this Gospel of Women. And the commentary said that Luke is the gospel that introduces women's leadership. I feel that the gospel of liberation is always necessary, especially these days when so many marginalized groups in our society are being used as scapegoats in the political arena.
Yeah.
In times as such, the attack against the trans community, immigrants, the right of women to choose, have become cheap banners to appease those who profess a very narrow God. A God is so limited kindness that sends everyone to hell if these are not straight, US born, white or men. As they are the ones going to heaven. I don't want to. I think by now you know what I'm heading, or what this message is about. Maybe for some, the widow in this parable appears weak. Maybe her image resembles the solitude of those who claim justice in a world that often ignores them. In her world, in those times, she was alone. The society of those times, as you might know, treated women without a man's protection as they were invisible. And maybe this widow represents the people of Gaza begging to stop the bombs that are killing them. Maybe this widow is like those who are work constantly to stop the degradation of our planet. Siblings, there is nothing weak in believing that justice will come and that we will come one day. There is nothing weak in the persistence of this widow. What if her begging is a strength? What if her insistence is the hope in the heart that we can have in a world that values peace? As I think of this widow, I think of other social justice struggles that have happened before. I want to share a couple of them with you because they have the same qualities of this widow: the firmness, determination, and persistence. The mothers of Plaza de Mayo, they led a peaceful resistance movement against the military dictatorship and repression of Argentina in response to the forced disappearance of their sons and daughters. Courageously, In the middle of the dirty war, a time of great repression in Argentina, the mothers began demonstrating every Thursday in silent marches in a large plaza of Mayo in Buenos Aires, a site of Argentina's government. To identify each other, the women would began wearing a white head scarf. They said it represented a baby diaper, and also it symbolized the white dove of peace. This women's presence made the government of Argentina very uncomfortable because the international community started paying attention. And later, these mothers were instrumental in the long process of reunification with the grandchildren who were born where their sons and daughters were in captivity and were given in unlawful adoptions to the military. Their presence was powerful as they chanted, "We don't forget, we don't forgive, we are still resisting." Another example of having persistent hope was the Montgomery bus boycott of the civil rights movement. We have heard often of Rosa Parks, and in putting together this sermon, I found this great resource called Learning Justice. It's a website that has deeper analysis of the different moments of the civil rights movement. For instance, there is a sound recording of Rosa Parks, whose name as the spark of the boycott in her, and in her trial for civil disobedience. There is this recording when the judge is asking her, "You said in your declaration that you were warned by the bus driver that he was going to call the police on you and that you were not afraid." And she answers, "Yes, Your Honor, I was not afraid." This website, Learning Justice, explains how Rosa Parks can not be seen in a historical vacuum, that her tiredness was not only from a long day of war when she refused to give up her seat, but it came from her own struggle as an actress. The Montgomery bus strike was organized to demonstrate that blacks of this city represented an economic force. And they went about the blacks organizing rides with friends and families or walking long distances, but refused to use public transportation. 13 months later, the Supreme Court was ruling that segregation on public buses is unconstitutional. So, dear siblings, annoying persistence wins. Annoying persistence and insistence is holy. And this passage is not just about Jesus teaching about praying all the time. It's not only about bringing things to the presence of God. It is also about making things that make things happen with our actions. Because what is prayer anyway? Is the spoken and the unspoken and the wish and the actions of our hearts to bring dignity for all. And prayer will be this quiet moment with our God for what is in our hearts, but also prayer is happening in the streets and marches, avoiding polls, insisting and persisting that justice prevails. So I invite us to be as annoying as hell and persist for peace. Amen.
Y en lo que hemos estado.
write to our giving page, you can mail a check, you can set up online giving regularly. There are many ways to give, and we graciously accept all of it. And, you know, we need your money. So if you would, the ushers would go now, and Dave, would you play something wonderful for us? Thank you.
Well, I give to you.
Thank you.
Yep.
Very much. Amen.